Last class, you have learnt transcription unit 10 gene and transcription in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In this class, we will see genetic code and table, then types of mutation. Let's see genetic code. Already you know genetic information which is transferred from parent to offspring on the basis of inheritance. The process begins with replication of DNA followed by transcription and translation. During transcription, genetic information stored in the DNA is copied into another form of RNA. The whole process is managed by the complementary base pairs of the two nucleic acids. However, the latter process of translation is not controlled by complementary, but by the genetic code. Translation is the process of converting nucleic acid information into amino acids. Now we will discuss about genetic code. The genetic code comprises the complete information of the protein manufactured from RNA. It is the sequence of base pairs of amino acids that code for protein to be synthesized. Thus, a change in this sequence can alter the formation of amino acids. Decoding the genetic code was a real challenge for scientists. One of the scientists, Sharge, suggested a solution to break this challenge. He applied the concepts of permutation and combination to decipher this genetic code. He suggested that genetic code should be made of 3 nucleotides which code for 20 amino acids with 4 bases. 4 nitrogenous bases and 3 nucleotides together form a triplet codon which codes for 1 amino acid. Thus, the number of possible amino acids would be 4 cube, that means 64. But we have 20 naturally existing amino acids. Let's see genetic table. The complete set of relationships among amino acids and codon is said to be genetic code, which is often summarized in a table. It can be seen that many amino acids are shown in the table by more than one codon. Already I said to you 20 amino acids and their short term. Here a codon means a sequence of the 3 nucleotides which together form a unit of genetic code in a DNA or RNA molecule. Let's see the features of genetic code. It is a triplet. Out of 64 codons, 61 codons code for amino acids and 3 codons do not code for any amino acids. Hence, they function as stop codons. They are UAA, UAG and UGA. One codon codes for only one amino acid. So, it is known as unambiguous and specific codons. That is CCG code for proline. It will not code for any other amino acid. Some amino acids are coded by more than one codon. That code is called as degenerate code. The codon is read in messenger RNA in contiguous fashion. That means sharing a common border touching. There are no punctuations. The code is nearly universal. For example, from bacteria to human, triple U would code for phenylalanine. Some exceptions are found in mitochondrial codons and in some protozoans. AUG performs dual functions. It codes for methionine and also acts as initiator codon. Let's see mutation and genetic code. It helps to study the relationships between genes and DNA. Mutation is the change that occurs in our DNA sequence due to environmental factors such as UV light or due to the mistakes caused when the DNA is copied. The mutation are of 3 types. They are point mutation, frame shift mutation and silent mutation. Now we will see one by one. First one is point mutation. It occurs due to change in single base pair. For example, sickle cell anemia. It is caused by the substitution of glutamic acid by valine at the sixth position of the beta globin chain of the hemoglobin molecule. Effect of point mutation that inserts or deletes a base in structural gene can be better understood by the following simple example. Consider a statement that is made up of the following words, each having three letters like genetic code. Ram has red cap. If we insert a letter B in between has and red and rearrange the statement, it would read as follows. Ram has BREDCAP. Similarly, if we now insert two letters at the same place, BI, now it would read Ram has BIREDCAP. Now we insert three letters together, say big. The statement would read Ram has big red cap. The same exercise can be repeated. By deleting the letters R, E and D one by one and rearranging the statement to make a triplet word. Ram has EDCAP, Ram has DCAP, Ram has cap. The conclusion from above exercise is very obvious. Insertion or deletion of one or two bases changes the reading frame from the point of insertion or deletion. Insertion or deletion of the three or its multiple bases. Insert or delete one or multiple codon, hence one or multiple amino acids and reading frame remains unaltered from that point onwards. Such mutations are referred to as frame shift insertion or deletion mutations. This forms the genetic basis of proof that codon is a triplet and it is read in a contiguous manner. Third one is silent mutation. It occurs when a base change in a codon does not alter the amino acid coded. For example, if the codon AAA is altered to become AAG, the same amino acid lysine will be incorporated into the peptide chain.